insurance. Solutions were proposed for the consideration of the administration president. The work of the panel is spelled out in detail in the written report I so submit.
Mr. Vincent Cheng will address the council on the report of the panel on environmental affairs 2020-2021. Mr. Vincent Cheng. Thank you. Mr. President, as Chair of the Panel on Environmental Affairs, I table the panel's work report for 2020-2021 into the Council and give a summary of the panel's work. The government announced in February this year the Waste Blueprint for Hong Kong 2035, setting out the vision of waste reduction, resources circulation, zero landfill. The Waste Blueprint outlines the strategies, goals and measures to tackle the challenge of waste management up to 2035. The panel urged the government to step up support for waste reduction and recycling, in particular measures relating to the management of waste plastics and food waste recycling. Members also in general supported the government's implementation of Producer Responsibility Scheme, PRS, on plastic beverage containers and scheme on regulation of disposable plastic tableware, and urged the government to enact legislation as soon as possible to phase out personal care and cosmetic products containing microbeads. Members also suggested that the government should expedite the development of waste to resources, energy and infrastructure to minimise Hong Kong's reliance on landfills and to minimise as much as possible the environmental nuisance caused by landfill operations. Restored landfills should be utilised for the development of farming and provision of other community facilities with pressing needs. Members also suggested that the government should expand the recycling network, enhance recycling support for residents of three new buildings, and consider ways to encourage private development projects to provide more recycling facilities. On improving air quality, members in general supported measures under the government's Clean Air Plan for Hong Kong 2035 and Hong Kong Roadmap on popularization of electric vehicles. They urged the government to formulate specific directions for popularizing electric commercial vehicles and encourage developers and owners to provide more charging facilities for their parking spaces, expediting the development of intelligent transport system and discontinuing new registration of fuel-propelled private cars as soon as possible to achieve zero vehicular emissions. On conservation, members suggested that the government should allocate more resources and deploy new technologies to strengthen law enforcement of restricted area at the sandy beach at Cham Wan on Lemma Island and step up efforts on combating illegal fishing to enhance the protection of green turtles. Members also urged the government to set a clear goal for managing local wild pig population. The panel also supported the motion moved by Ms. Elizabeth Quad to add certain offences under the Protection of Endangered Species of Animals and Plants Ordinance to Schedule 1 to Organised and Serious Crimes Ordinance, with a view to strengthening the combat against illegal wildlife trade. The amendment came into effect in the end of August this year. Mr. President, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank panel members and the Secretariat for their support in the past year. Thank you.